How do you like the conference so far?
Oh, it's great. Yeah? I've gotten to interact with a lot of people that I wouldn't normally get to see and talk to face to face. One of my longtime JavaScript idols, I guess you could say.
Who's that?
Dean Edwards.
Okay.
I think this is actually his first appearance at a conference. Okay. That's
so
great.
You bombed him with a lot of questions?
I did. I asked him so many questions about all the work he's done. And I've learned a lot, too.
Okay.
And I love watching all the presentations.
Okay.
You know.
Okay. You had a presentation about object-oriented design for web applications. Could you tell me what's the big difference for with regular application object-oriented programming and for web applications?
I think it's really similar. I'm trying to take some of the ideas that some of the design patterns that people use in regular applications and apply them to web applications. I basically just, you know, show how to use these design patterns you know, in your web applications to make them easier to design, easier to maintain, easier to extend, and stuff like that.
Okay, what are the pros for object-oriented for web applications?
Like I just said, I think that, you know, since our brains kind of naturally work in terms of objects and their relationships, makes things easier to design.
Okay.
And then your solutions are easier to, I mean, you can work with them more, you can extend them more, you can add to them. And I mean, since, you know, now is the time where everything grows, all of our solutions end up being 10 times bigger than we had expected.
Okay.
You know, we have features we need to add and things like that.
Okay.
So it's important to have a solution that you can extend and you can add to easily.
Okay. When would you not use object-oriented programming?
I kind of gave an example yesterday.
Yeah.
You don't want your code to be bloated, so you want to use it. You use discretion when you use it. If you have a simple form, you know, and you need to validate that there's a value inside the user input before you make a round trip to the server,
yeah.
I mean, you really don't need an object-oriented solution for that. It's just a simple function or something like that. But when you're building complex solutions and you're building, you know, more in-depth things, I mean, it's kind of it's good to at least evaluate the approach,
okay.
At least use it as an idea.
You also talked about prototyping.
Okay.
Can you explain shortly what it is?
Absolutely. So basically we can add functionality to the language by, you know, adding methods to the native types. So the native types, when I talk about that, I mean like array and number and string and things like that. And we can add methods to the prototypes, and then by doing that we can use those methods in, you know, throughout our applications.
Okay. You were talking about the phrase you said was keep things dry. What do you mean by that?
Anytime you have functionality that's used over and over again, you want to kind of factor it out and then pull in that functionality. So it's kind of don't repeat yourself.
Yeah.
If you have some kind of algorithm or some kind of functionality that you're using over and over again, you know, make it as simple to add to other cases as possible.
Okay. Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Keep it.
Don't repeat yourself.
Yeah, okay,
yeah.
Perfect.
Don't write code twice.
I want to, please. You were using MooTools. Why?
I'm one of the developers for MooTools. I found it a long time ago, and I thought that it was kind of when it started, it was an up-and-coming, it had a lot of potential, it was an up-and-coming framework, and I liked that it did things a little differently.
Okay.
Things were organized differently, and me and the lead developer who started it had a lot in common, and we were friends, and I think I use it because I've been using it for so long.
Okay,
and
so
I love
you know it,
so
it by heart.
I know it very well, and I love it very much.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
So I use it every day.
Okay. Well, thank you very much. Have a nice time in Amsterdam.
You're very welcome. Thank you so much.
Thank you.